Our family's been farming here in Columbia County for all of my life and then 20 or 30 years before that. Our focus has been on protecting the farmland out here. We've had a lot of flooding and the soil isn't as good in certain areas out here, and that's part of what we're gonna widen out and put the floodplain back to work.
Our primary focus is on salmon recovery, but as we've learned more and worked with landowners, we've seen, you know, if we can give the river a little bit of space, there's just so many multiple benefits to that for the ag community, for flooding, for citizens downstream, and just for the environmental condition and the ecosystem.
This is part of a 3-mile-long project along this river, the North Touchet. We're working under a umbrella philosophy that the tribes call the River Vision, which is really meant to, you know, not only restore habitat, but to improve the hydrology and geomorphic and biological function of the river. This year we reached out to Floodplains by Design and put in a grant application with them, and that's going to allow us to take this project all the way to completion over the 3-year period.
Over the last decade or so, we've realized that we're losing the battle on protecting communities against flood risk. Floodplains by Design is a public and private sector partnership. The Department of Ecology, the Puget Sound Partnership, and our private sector partners, the Nature Conservancy, we're trying to tackle both the flooding risk to our communities and the restoration of the ecosystem of the floodplain itself.
So through the years, you know, when we work on rivers after floods, we'd have people that were good with tractors and people that knew how things worked well previously and whatnot. But with this project, when you're working with hydraulic engineers, you're working with geological engineers, you can do modeling to see how the river is performing at 20-year floods, 30-year floods, 50-year floods. And when we worked on the rivers in the past, we didn't have those tools.
The closer you can get to a natural process, the better it is for everyone. And in some places, we don't have that luxury just because of, you know, what's occurring in the watershed. But in places where we do have that option and we've got willing landowners, we feel like we can really have a win-win situation. And that's where Floodplains by Design really fits in with this. It's kind of the nexus where we can get work done here in southeastern Washington that's beneficial for multiple folks.
My neighbors are curious about what I'm doing. They want to know what I'm doing. They want to know how I feel about it. And I'm pretty excited about it to them, and I can talk to them about the problems we have and how we've dealt with the problems and how we've come up with solutions and how we've developed trust. And trust is a big thing, and it goes both ways.
The reason why this project is important is it shows collaboration between tribal agencies, government agencies, and private landowners. And that's not an easy nexus to form. And by us being out here, we can find common ground and get these projects on the ground.
It's rewarding to be able to see something that you've talked about for a long time, collaborated with people, you know, built partnerships and working relationships, and then actually get something done, I think is really cool.